This is the moment that transformed India. This picture captures the signing of the Constitution of India on 24th January 1950. The Constitution of India is a book that defines the fundamental values and frameworks for our country. Do you know that the Constitution of India was written over a period of almost 3 years? The sessions began on 9th December 1946 and ended on 26th November 1949. During this time, the makers of the Constitution met for a total of 165 days over 11 sessions. This does not count the time for smaller committee meetings that they had. Do you know how many people wrote the Constitution of India? There were 389 before partition and 299 after that, as nearly one-fourth of the members moved to newly formed Pakistan. The people who wrote the Constitution were members of a Constituent Assembly that was established in 1946. 292 members were elected by the provincial legislative assemblies and 97 were nominated, mostly by the princely states. The representation was sought to be as diverse as possible. All regions were represented. Do you know who represented your region? It would be exciting to find out. Different communities were represented. Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, Parsis, Anglo-Indians, Christians, scheduled castes and tribes. Members were from diverse professions also. There were lawyers, social activists, teachers, politicians, journalists, industrialists, and they represented a wide spectrum of political parties like the Congress, Muslim League, Unionist, Communist, Scheduled Caste Federation, and others. A wide array of political ideologies was present, from the right, center, and left, and all shades in between. There is an interesting speech by Shyama Prasad Mukherjee in the Constituent Assembly where he points out the diversity of people present there. There was also representation of women. Do you know how many women were present? A total of 15. This was a major accomplishment for the time when women's empowerment was a faraway dream. Citing complications and difficulties, the British wanted to write the Constitution for India before they left. This idea was rejected by the Indians. We wanted to write the Constitution for ourselves, but we really had to struggle to claim this right from the British. It is worth noting here that the Constitution of Japan was written by 24 male Americans in 7 days flat. The only Japanese in the room was a young woman interpreter. While the decision to write the Constitution ourselves was a noble one, in reality, it was quite a difficult task to implement. One simple example is, with members speaking so many languages, it was difficult to even agree on the language in which the discussions would be had and the Constitution would be written. It was agreed that the members could speak in any language they want and the Constitution would be written in English and translated at once into Hindi. The process of drafting the Constitution was accompanied by extensive research. Constitutions of different countries were studied and they inspired some aspects of our Constitution. For example, fundamental rights and independence of the judiciary from the Constitution of United States of America, while directive principles of state policy from the Constitution of Ireland. 17 committees were formed in the Constituent Assembly. These committees focused on different subjects such as the fundamental rights, tribal areas, union powers, etc. They prepared their reports. These reports were reviewed and compiled into a draft constitution. This was discussed and reviewed by the members of the Constituent Assembly and redrafted twice more until the final document, which we know as the Constitution, was achieved. The drafting committee led by Dr. Ambedkar played a pivotal role throughout this rigorous and deliberative process. It was supported ably by the constitutional advisor B.N. Rao and the chief draftsman S.N. Mukherjee. The final powerful outcome was the Constitution of India with 22 parts, 395 articles and 8 schedules. The original copies were handwritten in English by Prem Narayan Raizada and in Hindi by Vasant Krishna Vaidya. All the illustrations were made by a team of artists from Shantiniketan, led by Nandlal Bose. The Constitution of India was enacted on 26th November 1949. This is celebrated as Constitution Day. The Constitution was enforced on 26 January 1950, and this is celebrated as Republic Day. When the Constitution was prepared, the environment was hugely challenging. Partition, religious right, division on the basis of caste, weak role of women, and so on. And yet, the makers chose the fundamental human values of justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity as our core constitutional values, and ensured that laws would protect these principles. The noted historian Granville Austen put it aptly: fundamental rights were to be framed amidst the carnage of fundamental wrongs. These values also form the foundation for discussions and decisions on different subjects. For example, one subject was who can vote. While debating over the qualification of voting and principles of representation, a discussion was also held on whether only educated people should be given the right to vote. This was opposed on the principle of equality, and finally, all citizens, irrespective of educational qualification, caste, religion, or gender, got their right to vote. At this point, it is worth noting that in America, black people got their right to vote 80 years and women got this right 133 years after the US Constitution came into being. The Constituent Assembly went on to debate several critical issues, including fundamental rights, minority rights, women's rights, union-state relations, governance structures, welfare measures, and so on. These debates and the Constitution itself guide us on making sense of our issues today. All the proceedings of the Constituent Assembly are documented and available online. Copies of the Constitution are also available in different languages. Reading these from time to time will guide us to examine our present and play our role as citizens more effectively in the future.